Welcome to microprocessor and interfacing playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain programmable interval timer IC, and there are two versions of it, 8254 and 8253. 8254, that is little advanced version of 8253, but you will be finding working of both of the ICs are almost identical. We will see what are the difference which is there in between these two ICs. But working of 8254 and 8253 both are identical. And to explain this IC, programmable interval timer, these are my session outlines where I'll explain basics of 8254, working of 8254, control signals of 8254, block diagram of 8254, control registers of 8254, and applications of 8254. So these are my session outlines. Let us begin this session with first point, that is basics of 8254. Now see, 8254 functions like software design counter or timers. So 8254, that has been working like software designed counter or timer. It generates accurate time delays. 8254 includes three identical 16-bit counters, and that can operate in six different modes. So I'll explain all three timers or counters that is there in 8254 and how many modes that is there, how to select those modes, also all those things that we will see in control register explanation of 8254. So basically 8254 is having three different identical 16-bit counters, and that is functioning in six different modes. 8254 can operate in DC to 8 GHz frequency, while 8253 that can operate with DC to 2 MHz of frequency. So 8254, that is advanced version of 8253. Initially 8253 was there, which was working with DC to 2 MHz of frequency, and then after advanced version of that timer that has been made, which is having operation frequency from DC to 8 MHz, that is there with 8254. 8254 includes status back command, and that can latch count and the status of counter. So that status back command that is not there with 8253, which can latch count and the status of counter. So this new feature that is there with 8254, which is not available with 8253. Now let us have a basic understanding for 8254, which explains how it functions. So as I have told, 8254, that is 16-bit counters, and there are basically three identical counters which is there with 8254. So how those counters are working, let us see that. So 16-bit count is loaded in its register first. So once you load 16-bit count, on giving command, it is begin to count, and to count it, it will decrement until it reaches to zero. So on initially, we need to load 16-bit count in register, and then based on command which is given to it, it will start to decrement one by one until it reaches to zero. At the end of count, it generates pulse, and that can be used to interrupt microprocessor. So at the end of count, it generates pulse, which is been utilized to interrupt microprocessor. The counter either in binary or BCD, and how to select binary or BCD count, that is what I'll explain in control register. So basically 8254, that is having three different counters. All three counters are made up of 16 bits. That is functioning in six different modes. That count can be done either in binary or in BCD. First, we need to load count into register, and based on command given to 8254, it will begin to count, and it will start to decrement that counter until it reaches to zero. Once it reaches to zero, it will give interrupt to microprocessor. So this is how 8254 is functioning. Now let us see how many control signals which is there with 8254. So in 8254 there are basically 5 different control signals which is most important: read bar, write bar, chip select and A0 A1. Read bar signal, that is being given by microprocessor to read the data. Write bar, that is to write the data. And chip select, that is to select the chip. A0 and A1, that is selecting counter. If A0 A1, that is 00, it will select counter 0. If it is 01, it will select counter 1. If it is 10, it will select counter 2. And if it is 11, it will select control register. So by selecting control register, we can set mode of operation and which type of counter that is there with 8254 that we can justify. So first of all, we should know how we can select counters and control register. By having A0 and A1 terminal, we can select counter and control register. If it is 00, we will be selecting counter 0. If it is 01, we will be selecting counter 1. If it is 10, we will be selecting counter 2. And if A1 and A0, that is 11, then we will be selecting control register. So let us see first of all what is the block diagram of it, and then we will see how control register is operating. So see, in block diagram, as I have told you, there are 5 control signals: read bar, write bar, A0, A1 and chip select. Chip select is to select this 8254 chip. Read bar, that is the signal given by microprocessor to read the status. Write bar is to write the status. A0 and A1, that is to select counter. If this A0, A1, that is 00, this counter 0 will get selected. If it is 01, it will select counter 1. If it is 10, it will select counter 2. And if it is 11, then it will select control register. So it will select this register. And when you have control register at that time, by exchanging data through D0 to D7, we can exchange data to this 8254. So if we place data on 8254, we can load counter data, and that counting will be getting done individually. Like see, if counter 0 is selected, it will be counting data based on clock and gate input, and it will give output over here. And similar case is there for counter 1, counter 2. So to justify the total number of count, we need to select control register, and control register will get selected by A0 and A1 is equals to 11. Now see, if you have control register getting selected by having A0 and A1 is equals to 11, you can be placing data D0 to D7, and that is assigning control register data. So control register from D0 to D7, that is as per BCD M0, M1, M2, read write 0, read write 1, SC0, SC1. Now see, this first bit D0, BCD, so that justifies if it is 0, there will be binary counter of 16 bit. If it is 1, then there will be BCD counter of 4 decades. So here this bit D0, that will justify whether this counter is binary or BCD. If it is 0, counter will be binary. If it is 1, counter will be BCD. In binary there will be 16 bit, and in BCD there will be 4 decades. This M0, M1 and M2, that will select mode of operation. If it is 001, mode 0, 000, mode 0, 001, mode 1, don't care 10, mode 2, don't care 11, mode 3, 100, mode 4, 101, mode 5. So that is how 6 different modes are there with 8254. Now there is read write 0 and read write 1. So if read write 0, that is 00, counter latch operation will happen. If it is 01, read write of least byte is happening, or one can say read write of significant least byte is happening. If it is 10, then read write of most significant byte is happening. If it is 11, then it will be writing or reading first significant byte and then least significant byte and then most significant byte. So that is how read write operation that happens. So this will justify counter latch command, read write of most significant byte and least significant byte. So for 01 only least significant byte, for 10 only most significant byte, and for 11 first least and then most significant byte read write will happen. And SC0 and SC1, so that will select counter. So if it is 00, select counter 0. If it is 01, select counter 1. If it is 10, select counter 2. And if it is 11, read back command, that is what we can give by using control register. So see, these are the 7 bits that will select modes, that will select counter, that will do read and write operation of counter, that will select whether this counter is BCD or binary. So this is what about control register of 8254 or 8253. Now let us sum up this session by having applications of 8254, 8253. So 8254 or 8253, that we can use it for real time clock, for event counter, a digital one shot and square wave generator. So these are major applications which is there with 8254, and people have made so many projects, basic level projects, by using 8254 or 8253 IC. I hope that you have understood this session. You can give your valuable feedback. Definitely based on your feedback, in future I'll make videos to sort out all those queries which is there with you. Thank you so much for watching this video.